WPG, Talk Radio 1450. My name is Mel Taylor. Remember that. It's the Mel Taylor Show every Friday afternoon from 3 until 6. It's radio, talk radio, for those with those synapses still firing.
Let's see here.
Hi, WPG Talk Radio. Who's this?
Hey, it's Gary Hill. How are you? Happy New Year to you and your listeners.
Oh, wow. So my very first MBCA
kickoff
to a new year over there at Harris. You represent a variety of things, but explain who Gary Hill is and what the MBCA is, how important it is.
Sure. The MBCA is a local business civic organization in existence for over 25 years. I am the community relations director. We do have a charitable arm, and we love to give back to our community. We also have a scholarship foundation that we run, and we give scholarships to students and to teachers. But more importantly as well, we also are an advocate for positive growth in the area, in our residential communities, and in particular in our business community. So we are an organization that has members as residents who live in our area, nonprofits who belong and are active in our area, as well as politicians, government agencies, large and small businesses throughout the region, not just Atlantic City. We present various forums throughout the year, about five or six different forums, where it's a great networking opportunity. As you saw the other day, we had over 1,000 people at the Harris Business Center. A lot of our people have never been to the Harris Business Center on the waterfront, so it was a great way to experience that, and they can possibly look at that and say, we might want to do an event here, we might want to hold a convention here. So we're helping to promote business, helping to promote great positive energy for the region.
So you're saying, Gary Hill, you're saying that I was reporting that it was 800 plus. Are you saying 1,000 people?
Yeah, we had to add a few tables at the end. Of course, all the news happening the day 24 hours before, I think, kind of boosted those numbers a little bit.
Yeah.
But, that's the way it was. And we had, of course, an immense amount of media there from all over the tri-state area, New York, Philadelphia, and the Atlantic City area, because of the issues, of course, facing Atlantic City at the last 24 hours.
I don't know how you are able to corral 1,000 people. And I'm telling you, when I walked in, you looked at me. For a moment there, I thought you didn't know who I was, but you're so...
Of course I knew who you were. I was just working, Mel.
No, what I mean is that you're so focused that you have 1,000 people that you have to basically take care of. So I was totally appreciative how you are just focused on getting people in there, greeting people. And I'm telling you, that event this past Wednesday at noon, anybody was in that room that afternoon.
Well, thank you. You know, it's a lot of work, 25 years of work, and we continue that. I'm starting to work on my next event already, of course, the day after. But, it's a great way to bring the community together. We had, I think, every major Atlantic City civic organization leader was there. We had many politicians. We had all of City Council, or most of City Council. Of course, it was the unofficial State of the City by the mayor of the city. Every January we do that, no matter who the mayor is, and we've done it for 23 years. And so they kind of lay out their plans, their goals for the region, for the city. And so we were very happy to be able to host that and the first organization to be able to show Mayor Guardian's vision, his progress from last year, and, of course, his goals for this year. So that, it's work, but we had a lot of many great community leaders there, business corporates. I think we had 5 out of 8 casino presidents there. So that's great. You know, it's just a matter of bringing the community together and letting our members and guests being able to network and reach out to some of these people that perhaps they cannot do so easily on themselves.
And now, Gary, for those, that small group of people that do not know about the benefit, they don't know about the benefits of the MBCA, how can they reach out? What website address can they reach out to learn more?
Thank you for asking. It's a very reasonable membership. It's like belonging to a club. It's literally a business civic club. And it's www.mbcanj, that's like New Jersey, .com. And there's information on some of the upcoming events. There will be a video on our last event, which was Wednesday. It's not up there yet. And, of course, also about our scholarship program. We just honored in November our last event of 15. We honored Pinky Kravitz, who was a great community leader in media as well as the community. So that was our last event of 15. We now kicked off 16 with the State of the City, and we move forward to our winter event, which will be March 7th of 2016 at the Claridge Hotel here in Atlantic City.
If there's one event that you need to go to and that you can meet everybody in one fell swoop. This event at the beginning of the year is the event of the season.
It really is. And, you know, we've established this tradition, as I said, for 20-some years, and we move it around to various members' properties. We've had it at Caesars and Bally's and Trump and Resorts. We usually need a pretty big venue for it because we do have a minimum usually of 700, 800 people. As I mentioned, we had over 1,000. I think it was 1,050, I believe, exactly. But anyway, we move it throughout the region. So, again, so people can have a different experience at different areas, different business venues. And we wanted to highlight Harrah's there. They spent a lot of money over there. We wanted to highlight them. So it was an opportunity for some of our business leaders to say, hey, look, this is what's new in our area. Look at the money they invested into our community. We're very grateful to Harrah's for hosting us. We had a great sponsor. It was a security company that does a lot of business in the area. They got to speak to other business owners. So it's a great way to reach out to the business community and to the community itself.
Let me tell you, talk about cool. Under pressure. Mayor Don Guardian, before the festivities starts, before they start at noon, right? We're talking about, it just was 24, 48 hours prior that all of a sudden, I call it a sucker punch, but all of a sudden Mayor Don hears these things about municipal takeovers. He does an 11:30 press conference in the same building at Harrah's around the corner. So he's focused and this guy is passionate. They're joining arms. Wow, what an emotional, powerful bunch of statements by not just Mayor Don, but we had councilmen there, we had freeholders there. Then when he's done that, and that's tough, all those cameras, he comes around the corner, he gets up on that stage, and he turns into the Mayor Don that we know, who is the world's greatest mayor of a reinventing Atlantic City.
Right, our cheerleader, for real. And, you know, it was a very difficult 24 hours, as you mentioned, Mel, and you're absolutely, I totally agree, it was a sucker punch. I mean, wow. And nobody knew anything that was coming. And literally, I had gotten an email early Tuesday morning from the mayor's office saying, we finished our presentation Monday night. We just threw it out Tuesday morning. We're on our way to Trenton. We're going to rewrite Tuesday night. And I think the mayor mentioned that. And, you know, he really did a remarkable job with the limited information that he had, because not all the information was out yet and still isn't, I don't believe. And so he did an amazing job for over 1,000 people. And I believe he really asked, as you saw, he asked for everybody's help for the positivity of Atlantic City. And yes, we have our problems. Yes, we have our issues. But together, we need to keep strong to keep our own destiny in our own hands.
Talk about class. He's getting beat up in the media. He's getting beat up from Trenton. And he still gives kudos and gives thanks to people like Mr. Sweeney and other people who are kind of taking swipes at him. He still thanks them publicly up on the big screens, the PowerPoints in front of 1,000 people. That's class, Mr. Guardian.
I agree with you, Mel, and you're right. And he did thank the people that did help, has helped in the 2 years of transition that we're going through and the progress. We've made an immense amount of progress. Why exactly now is the right time for this supposedly state takeover? Probably beyond my pay grade. I have my own on that. But, you know, it's the people elect people in our community, in our area, no matter where you live, Atlantic City, Linwood, I don't care, Port Republic, you elect people to represent you. There's a reason that you're an elected official. And for that, for somebody or for some reason, whatever those reasons are, to supersede that just by executive order or by legislative move, it just doesn't seem very American to me. But, you know, again, it's a very tough time right now.
So let's remind everybody before we say goodbye, what's coming up next for the MBCA?
Thank you. March 7th is our annual winter charity mixer, where we pick one of our nonprofits as a member. This year, it's the Atlantic County Toys for Kids program, who does great work throughout the county. And it's a $30 fee for a ticket. You come to the Claridge, their new ballroom, which is beautiful, something we can highlight. You're going to get some great food. Eddie Morgan's jazz trio is going to be there, some special guests. It's a cash bar. And the $30 will go to pay a little bit of it pays for the food. The rest of it, about 20 of it, goes to the Atlantic County Toys for Kids. We give them a check for their programs, and we like to support one of our nonprofits. Very easy, lots of fun, lots of great people to mix with and to network with in the middle of winter. So that's March 7th at the Claridge, and you can buy your tickets online or, of course, order them by telephone. And the number is 348-1903.
You know, you should be on radio, man. You have an awesome announcer voice. You get it all, and you did it unscripted, I bet.
That's correct, but that's good. That's because I had good leadership with Mel. So you know what you're doing. You've been there.
And
listen, you know, we appreciate all the support you give everybody in our community events and business organizations. And we are just very proud to be part of your team there as well. And we look forward to speaking with you in the near future, Mel. Happy New Year.
All right. Do I give you a clue as to who I think will be on the beach this summer? Is that too much of a clue? Duh. He's even from Jersey, so I'm pretty sure a bus can get from where he lives to here. It's WPG Talk Radio 1450. My name is Mel Taylor, and this is Bon Jovi. He's talking about unions being on strike. So no, get Bob McDevitt on the phone. You know, Local 54.
Working for her man. She brings home her bed for love.
Could you imagine if Bon Jovi played the beaches of Atlantic City? Right, so was that too much of a clue?